and we're about to do the elimination method for Algebra 1. All right? Are we ready, class?
Ready.
All right. Okay, so we've done substitution method. Substitution method, we wrote two equations side by side. Elimination method, I'd recommend writing two equations, one on top of the other. So there we go. So, if these equations were next to each other in substitution method, we could solve this by now. Remember, we isolate one variable and plug it back. Okay. However, using elimination method is a different cup of tea. This time, the whole concept of elimination method is to add down within the equation. Add by columns, right? And I see a few faces of confusion, but don't worry, it's only been 30 seconds. Okay, so if we were to add down here, x plus x would be what?
2x.
Y plus negative y would be what?
Zero.
Negative 3 plus 1 would be what?
Zero.
Is this solvable?
Yes.
Yeah.
What is x?
X
is negative 1.
I like that method.
I like it too. It's actually my favorite method. It's usually many people's favorite method. But if it's not your favorite method, then I don't hate you. Okay. So, if x is negative 1, same thing applies. We come back to the top and we plug in. So,
how do you know which one to plug it in?
Either one. Because in this situation, there's only one answer. All right? So, our answer is negative 1, something for y. So, let's actually bring it here. So, Jordan, which one do you want to plug it in?
One.
First one, yeah, I plug it in here because it avoids the negatives too. So here we go. X plus y equals negative 3. Instead of x, what are we writing?
Negative
1.
Negative
1. Plus y equals negative 3.
Y equals negative 2.
Plus 1 plus 1. Y equals negative 2. Negative 2. And then you can plug it back in, both of them, into both equations to verify that it's correct. All right?
Yeah.
Questions so far? Okay, let's try another one. Yeah, I like this too. It's neat.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like, I don't know, like neato things. I mean, there's so many things that are neato. Okay. I mean, what do you want me to say? Like pizza?
Steak.
Does no justice. It's neato like elimination method. All right, so let's add down again. What do we get? 3x plus x is
4x.
Yeah, 4x. What happens here? Gone. 13 plus 7?
20.
20. Divide by 4.
X equals 5.
Wait.
I got it.
I like this. Why
do
we learn this first?
Because it's easier to go from hard to easy, I believe. Plus, it's like a tree, the end of the line. Yes, question.
Why wouldn't you subtract 3x minus x in the beginning?
If you subtract 3x minus x, you'll get 2x. And then you'd have to subtract this as well. And you would get negative 4y.
Uh-huh.
And then you'd subtract this as well, and you get 6.
Oh.
So, we would still be left with an equation with two variables. The whole process of elimination, the word elimination, means to eliminate one variable. Right? I always think of elimination like Terminator. But that's my own idea.
There's a new version of Terminator coming up.
That's very good. It's irrelevant right now. Thank you, though.
You're welcome.
Okay.
Okay.
So, we want to eliminate one version.
Do you always add it?
Okay, wait, I will.
Okay. You can add or subtract. However, I'd recommend adding always, because adding avoids the confusion of subtracting. If we subtracted, we would have to subtract the whole equation, and meaning distributing the negative.
Yeah.
You're allowed to do that, but let's get into a process of only adding. Question.
Once you have x equals 5, then like how do you get y?
You plug x equals 5 into any one of the two equations.
Either one.
The easier one.
Okay.
The easier one. So, which one would you like to plug it into?
The second one.
Let's plug it into the second one. So, I'm going to rewrite it. X plus 2y equals 7. So instead of x, what are we writing?
5.
5.
Plus 2y.
Plus 2y.
Equals 7.
7. Minus 5. Minus 5.
Divide.
Bring it up here.
2y
equals
2.
2. So y equals 1. So there's your pair.
Do you want us like to write the point?
Yeah, the point is the classic way. The point's the classic way to write.
That's 5.
So, and remember.
I thought we're supposed to do 3 times 5.
3 times 5?
Yeah, because like I.
Oh, you plugged it into the same.
I plugged it into this equation, the second equation.
Oh.
You can plug it into
whichever one you want.
You'll get the same answer.
You're going to get the same answer.
Really? I got it.
Let's do it for fun. If we plug x equals 5 into here, we'll get 15.
Minus
2. 15. Minus 2y equals 13.
Yeah,
minus 15 on both sides, you get negative 2y equals negative 2.
Oh, so can you do either way?
Either one.
Oh, okay.
Either one. Yes.
Why didn't you make it 15x?
Because x
because
is 5.
Because you already used the x.
Oh, okay.
All right, let's try another one.
Got it. This is so much shorter.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I like this.
I like you.
Bless you.
Thank you, everyone.
It's funny to have sneezes on camera. All right, so we have 6 all together. Here's number 3. 2x. Minus 5y. 2x. Minus 7y. Negative 6. Negative 14. Okay. So let's try that one. So.
Wait, I didn't even
know. Yeah, I'm gonna talk. I'm not gonna write.
Okay.
Yeah. If we were to add these, would that help us?
No.
So.
You get
4x. 4x.
Negative
4.
Minus
12. Minus 12y.
Equals
negative 20. Okay. So you just have another equation with two variables, and nothing was eliminated. Nothing was eliminated. So what can we do? So that one of the variables.
Wait, what do you mean nothing was eliminated?
Wait, what is it?
Okay, the idea. The idea is to the idea is to eliminate one variable like we've done the last two problems. When you add, one is positive something, one is negative something, they add together and they cancel. So I'm going to tell you this is a way to eliminate what I think you can see is the x. So what do we do?
Times by negative 5.
So we're going to multiply this equation by negative 1. Every piece of the equation we're multiplying by negative 1. However, usually when we're thinking in terms of subtraction, something minus something else. But it complete can be done. So here's the strategy, you guys. Don't be afraid of a little work. Rewrite both equations. Rewrite both equations with a line. 2x minus 5y equals negative 6. Here we go. Negative 1 times 2x is?
Negative 2x.
Negative 2x. Negative 1 times negative 7y is?
Plus 7y.
Plus 7y. Negative 1 times negative 14.
14.
14. Big mistake that people make is they forget to carry it all the way through. But that's not going to happen because we're stellar.
No, we're what's it? We're neato?
We're neato. Well, the math is neato and you are stellar. All right, so now what happens when we add? Look what happens.
X
cancels out.
Oh. So it doesn't always have to be y?
It does not always have to be y. It can be x.
Will it always work out, though? Will that always happen? Like, one of them will always...
If you make it happen.
Yeah.
By...
If you make it, do it by?
You have to decide, which one do I want to eliminate that's going to make my life easy? In this case, I'm going to eliminate the x.
And so it doesn't always have to be negative 1? You just
no,
the number?
It's going to be many things. And there's more examples coming.
Wait a second.
Is this part of 5-4?
5-3 and 5-4 are joined.
Like existence.
5-3 and 5-4 are the same. Okay. So it just went straight.
So joined at the hip.
So, what is negative 5y plus 7y?
2y.
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 Equals
8.
What? No,
equals.
What's wrong?
Oh, okay.
2y equals 8. I get the joke. Yeah, y equals 4. Now that y equals 4, let's take it back to the first one. Why not? So, we're going to plug y equals 4 into y here to solve for x. So, let's rewrite this. 2x minus 5y equals negative 6. 2x minus 5y, which is 4.
Wait, I have a question. If you were to do the second equation and not the first one, like when you plug it back in, would you do like the negative one, like when you've already...
No.
You would
stick
do
to the original. Always stick to the original. The reason you want to stick to the original is that it's possible that we made a mistake in our multiplying and we'd be plugging back into the wrong equation. So always plug back to the original.
I'll just do it to the other one.
Always, no. Just go to the original. Either one. I'm saying, what if we made a mistake multiplying by a negative 1 through here, and we plugged it into this one, for example. If we did it right, we'd
then
be okay.
You get the wrong answer.
You get the wrong answer. So let's plug into the original. Mm-hmm. Nothing beats original. I meant more than just math. Yes?
Can I do it?
Of course you can do it! What's 2x minus...
2x minus 20 equals negative 6. Plus 20. And then you get 2x equals 14.
2x equals 14.
And then 5, 2.
Yes.
And then you get x equals 7.
X equals 7. Your answer. 7, 4.
Yay.
Right? And just as a process of checking, to be thorough, you should check for both, but we'll check one for now to show you the idea. So, x is 7. So, 2 times 7, what would this be?
14.
14 minus... 5 times y, which is 4, 20, equals negative 6. Is 14 minus 20 negative 6?
Yes.
Yes. So this point, 7, 4, is a point on this line. Satisfies the equation. Question, yes?
I don't understand why you times, like, when we started the problem, when you times by negative 1, I don't understand.
Okay, that's the best question to ask because it's the heart of the matter. The reason we multiply, let me get up here. The reason to multiply by negative 1 is that we observe. Wouldn't it be great if I can add to 2x negative 2x? And that way, if you add 2x and negative 2x, they eliminate, leaving just y. So we need to look at the original problem and say, what can I add together? One positive, one negative, so that they eliminate. In this case, we're going to do the x. So when we multiply by negative 1, look what happens. Now 2x plus negative 2x is 0, and it's gone. So that's why we call it elimination. Yes, question.
Are we going to have to write one solution, or it'll always be one solution?
Okay, same rule applies. If you work this down and you get something that does not make sense, as in 4 equals 7, no sense, no solution. If you get something that equals 4 equals 4, what is it? What do we call it? Too much sense? Infinite solutions. Right, so you can jot that down too. If you get no sense writing, bigger thinking.
No.
4 equals 7.
I can see it.
I know.
No sense, 4 equals 7, no solution. And then you have too much sense, like 4 equals 4, or 0 equals 0. The answer would be infinite solutions. Solutions. Question, yes?
Yeah, okay, when we
plugged
y in.
We plugged y in, yeah.
Can we use the other equation?
Yes, use any equation you want, because it's going to work for both. That's the whole point.
Wait, with elimination, do we have to write no solution or implement solution?
Correct, correct. If this is your result, no solution. Meaning, x would cancel, y would cancel, and you'd have something like 0 equals. They're getting harder. Yay. Are you
afraid? No. I'm not afraid, I just don't like hard.
I won't delete, I won't. Don't delete.
Say no.
Backspace.
This is 10 cents.
10 cents? Alrighty. So, let's think about this, critically speaking. This will be our last one. Last problem. 2x minus 3y. Oh, looks like we're done.
Who's here?
Okay. Which equation do we multiply by what? Which equation?
Wait.
Which equation do we multiply by what?
Huh? Oh, 5 by 3.
Good. You can multiply the first one by 3. If we multiply this by 3, we'll get 3 times. Or, what?
Or you could multiply the first one by -2.
You can multiply by -2 as well. Let's do 3 to avoid negatives. Here we go. I'm going to race to the finish line here. 3. Rewrite both.
3x.
Rewrite both. 3x plus 3y equals 9. 2x minus 3y equals 16. That's good, she's into it. Here we go. Cancels. 5x
equals?
5. X equals 5. So plug it into the easy one. 5 plus what isn't 3?
-2. Yeah.
We just plugged it in here. Yeah.
No, plug it in that one.
No!
Olivia.
We could, but I'd rather make my life easy. If you want to make your life hard, that's your choice.
That's what I just said. Plug it in that
one. Oh, okay. I thought you meant this. All right. Can you cancel the... What? We plug X?
Oh, no.
Minus 5.
Yeah. All right, so you can...
Y equals negative
2. You can hit... you can end the day.
Bye,
world. Stay in school. Math is fun.
Wait a second.
Thank you, class.
Wait.
Of course you have homework.
Bye, 4.